Good afternoon, everyone, especially to Ma'am. Together with me and my group mates, we are the group 5, and we will discuss about the second phase of the 1886 Philippine Revolution and the reactions to American intervention. Now, I will call on the first person who will discuss, Madelo.
The Declaration of Philippine Independence also refers to as the Act of Proclamation of Independence by the Filipino people. It is a historical document that marked a pivotal moment in the Philippines' journey towards becoming a sovereign nation. The declaration was authored by Ambrosio Rianzares Bautista. Bautista was a prominent Filipino lawyer and patriot who played a crucial role in drafting the declaration and articulating aspirations for independence from Spanish colonial. The document was signed by 89 individuals representing a broad spectrum of Filipino society. This wide support underscored the collective desire for independence across different sectors and regions. Among the signatories was L.M. Johnson, a colonel from American Army. His presence and signature signifies the involvement and recognition of the United States in the Philippines' fight for independence. The declaration took place during a time of significant upheaval and struggle against Spanish colonial rule. It symbolizes the culmination of the Filipino people's fight for freedom and self-determination. This act led to the establishment of the Philippines' first republic and laid the foundation for the Philippines' journey as an independent nation. Understanding the Declaration of Philippine Independence is crucial as it highlights the Filipino people's resilience and determination to achieve sovereignty. It also reflects the historical context of international involvement, particularly the role of the United States during this period. The Declaration of Philippine Independence is more than just a historical document. It represents the collective will and enduring spirits of the Filipino people. Recognizing and studying this declaration helps us appreciate the sacrifice and efforts made towards achieving national independence.
The historic date of June 12 was set by Aguinaldo through a decree issued on June 5, 1898. The Philippine Revolution began in 1896 as a war of independence against Spanish colonial rule. On June 5, 1898, Aguinaldo issued at his house located in what was then known as Cavite El Viejo, proclaiming June 12, 1898 as Day of Independence. So, what is Independence Day? Independence Day in the Philippines is also known as Araw ng Kalayaan or Day of Freedom. It's celebrated annually on June 12. This day commemorates the Declaration of Independence from Spanish colonial rule on June 12, 1898 by Filipino Revolutionary Force led by General Emilio Aguinaldo. The declaration took place in Cahuete, Cavite and marked the end of over 300 years of Spanish colonization. Independence Day is a national holiday in the Philippines, marked by various ceremonies, parades, and cultural events across the country. So, the Acta de la Proclamación de la Independencia del Pueblo Filipino was solemnly read by its author, Ambrosio Rianzares Bautista. Aguinaldo War, Counselor and Special Delegate. The page 21 declaration was signed by 98 Filipinos appointed by Aguinaldo and one retired American artillery officer, Colonel L.M. Johnson. The next one is the Filipino Revolution began in 1896 as a war of independence against Spanish colonial rule. So, in the fall of 1896, Filipino nationalists revolted against the Spanish rule that had controlled the Philippines since the 16th century. It was the culmination of the 333-year colonial rule of Spanish to the archipelago. An anti-colonial secret organization led by Emilio Aguinaldo on 1869 to 1964. The 1896 revolt carried the Filipinos to an anticipated war with the Spain and an anticipated war with the United States. The historian suggests that the roots of the Philippine Revolution began with the building of the Suez Canal in 1869. With access to Europe, Filipinos were exposed to new ideas about freedom and returned home questioning Spanish rule. In 1872, there was a small revolt in the Cavite province which launched the revolutionary cause.
Ceasefire agreement was reached between Filipino and Spanish leader. The ceasefire agreement between Filipino and Spanish leader was reached with the signing of the Pact of the Biak na Mato on December 14, 1807. This agreement marked a temporary truce in the Philippines Revolution against Spanish colonial rule. Emilio Aguinaldo, a leader of the Filipino Revolutionary Force, and Spanish Governor General Fernando Primo de Vera negotiated the terms of the pact. The agreement included provision for the exile of key Filipino leaders to Hong Kong and the military settlement. However, the truce was short-lived and hostilities resumed eventually, leading to the continuation of the Philippine struggle for independence. And the outbreak of the Spanish-American War in 1898 brought the United States into the conflict. The outbreak of the Spanish-American War in 1898 indeed brought the United States into the conflict involving the Philippines. The war began April 18th after the explosion of the U.S. Marine in Havana Harbor, leading the U.S. to declare war on Spain. The U.S. saw an opportunity to weaken Spanish influence and expand its own territories. One of the first major actions of the war was the Battle of Manila Bay on May 1, 1898, where the U.S. Navy under Commodore George Dewey defeated the Spanish fleet in the Philippines. This victory effectively brought the Philippines into the conflict as the U.S. aimed to liberate the island of the Spanish rule. Subsequently, the U.S. supported Filipino Revolutionary Force led by Emilio Aguinaldo, who had returned from exile to lead the fight against the Spanish. However, tension later arose between a Filipino force and the U.S. culminating into the Philippine-American War after the Treaty of Paris 1898, which ended the Spanish-American War and ceded the Philippines to the United States. Shift to guerrilla warfare tactics by Filipino force. After the initial engagement in the Philippine-American War, the Filipino force led by Emilio Aguinaldo shifted to guerrilla warfare tactics in response to the superior military strength and resource the United States. This transition occurred around November 1899, following significant conventional defeats. Guerrilla warfare was characterized by small mobile units conducting hit and run attacks, ambush and sabotage against U.S. troops and installation. This strategy aimed to prolong the conflict, exhaust American force, and maintain Filipino resistance despite the disparity in conventional military capabilities. The Filipinos leveraged their knowledge of the local terrain, the support of the civilian population, and the element of surprise to disrupt and challenge the American occupation.
Good afternoon, ma'am. My report is about slide 11, and its key concept is the war was brutal with both sides resorting to extreme measures, resulting in significant civilian casualties and deaths from violence, famine, and disease. My explanation about this is because of the brutality of war in both sides, it results in significant civilian
who has suffered and many died from violence, famine, and disease caused by war because of its lack of supply, foods, medicines. Thank you.
The emergence of Philippine national consciousness during this period was driven by several factors. So, ang mga Pilipino sa una kay pagkamata og aware na sa mga nahitabo sa una during the second phase of Philippine Revolution tungod sa tungod ani ng mga rason. Abuses by the Spanish government, military, and clergy over 3 centuries of colonial rule, which were exposed by the Filipino ilustrados, which means educated class. In the late 19th century, this full resentment towards colonial rule due to the maltreatment which they experienced that time, the ilustrados or the educated class people established a movement that exposed conditions through a propaganda movement, reformed a national consciousness movement that arose among young Filipino immigrants in the late 19th century. The most well-known ilustrados are Graciano Lopez Haina, Marcelo H. Del Pilar, and Jose Rizal. Through writing a book and articles in their own language, they were able to depict what abuses the Filipino people experienced at their time. For example, sa Nuli May Tanghuri, na karakter ni Sisa, nagpakita nga ang mga babae sa una kay ginabuso sa mga Spaniards. Ang mga pangitabo sa una is kinapamagi ni Rizal sa iyang mga sulat o story. The growth of Filipino nationalism, which had been slow due to difficulties in social and economic intercourse, but became more united and in the face of the threat of Americanization, tungod sa dimayo na pagdala sa gobyerno sa Spanish sa una sa Pilipinas ug daghan mga Pilipino na not enough knowledge ug unsa jud ang tinuod og sakto sense, wala nakaskwela dali kasi sila mailad sa mga istorya ug bakak na ginaingon sa mga Spaniards busa na divide ang mga groups sa mga Pilipino sa una kay pataka ra tuto miskandi tinuod pero nagkaiusa ra tungod sa hulga sa Americanization, meaning kaon sa Amerika ang yuta sa lugar sa Pilipinas. And the third is peasant and local chieftains contradicting the goal of the first Philippine Republic. The goal of the first Philippine Republic to establish a sovereign, independent, and stable nation led by ilustrado class, in contrast to the interests of the peasants or poor and local farmers and local chieftains or leaders sa lugar, who made up the majority of the fighting forces. Kay supak man ang mga mag-uuma o leaders sa gagmayng lugar or barangay sa una, sa gusto may tabo sa First Philippine Republic, gusto sa mga local farmers nga di may tabo na mga estudyados or mga tao nga edukado ang magdala sa nasud. Magkahiusa ang mga local farmers o chieftains sa makigubot o pagpakita nga dili sila uyon. And lastly, Filipino Republic opposition to American annexation. The challenge of Aguinaldo and his generals to sustain unified Filipino public opposition to Americanization, which was the revolutionary strategic center of gravity. Kay halos mga Pilipino sa una di uyon sa tumong sa First Philippine Republic nga ilustrados magdala sa nasod sa Pilipinas. Nagkayusa ang mga Pilipino para dili lang yun matuman ang tumong sa mga ilustrados. Kay para nila og ilustrados magdala sa manasod utok rang na may tanong dili kasing-kasing. Kay wala sila kabalo sa side sa mga pobre og ilang needs. Gusto nila sa samara nila ang magdala sa nasod. Tao na makasabot og maminaw sa ilang opinion. Overall, the emergence of Filipino national consciousness during this period was driven by long-standing resentment towards colonial rule, the goal of establishing an independent nation, and the need to unify diverse social and political interests against the threat of American annexation.